He's one of the most powerful men in Turkey, but he doesn't live in Istanbul or Ankara. Rather, this Islamic cleric lives in small town Pennsylvania, in almost total seclusion. Fethullah Gulen has been widely reported to have ordered his followers and the police and the judiciary to pursue investigations into corruption at the top of the government. It wasn't me, he said. It was just the officials doing their job.
The investigating prosecutors and police did not know that these misdeeds were no longer considered as crimes, and they pursued this matter. This made the government unhappy, and as a result, they're talking about these officials being a state within a state.
The Turkish Prime Minister, Recep Tayyip Erdogan, used to be seen as an ally. But more recently, the Prime Minister has attempted to control the influence of Mr. Gulen's movement, ordering the closure of its school network, sacking police officers and prosecutors deemed to be Gulenists.
Fethullah Gulen's made enemies in the Turkish establishment before. He came to the US back in the 90s after he was charged with crimes against the state, charges he was later cleared of. But as we found from the scale of this estate, the movement that he now heads leverages enormous money and influence, which is why this current struggle matters.
If Prime Minister Erdogan succeeds in shutting out or basically co-opting the Fethullah Gulenist movement, there is no other social, political, or economic or security force in Turkey that he will not have control over, and that drives a dagger through the heart of pluralism.
On the other hand, said the ambassador, if the man who lives in these modest private quarters fends off the prime minister, there could be a danger to democracy in an unelected man outside the country dictating terms. So who would he support in this year's elections in Turkey?
If I will say something, it will be this. Vote for whoever stands for the rule of law and rights, for whoever is respectful of democracy. Everyone sees what's going on.
Fethullah Gulen is a frail man. Twice during the interview we stopped so that he could have his blood pressure taken. But his word, even from 8,000 kilometres away, has the power to shape the whole political landscape in Turkey. Tim Franks, BBC News, Pennsylvania.